సంవత్సరం కరోనా నియంత్రణలో భాగంగా లాక్డౌన్ విధించిన కారణంగా 10వ తరగతి పబ్లిక్ పరీక్షలు మధ్యలో ఆగిపోయాయి. విద్యార్థులు తమను తాముగా పరీక్షలకు సిద్ధమవుతున్న తరుణంలో మన మహబూబాబాద్ జిల్లా విద్యాశాఖ అధికారి ఈఎస్ఎస్ శర్మ గారు ఈ డిజిటల్ కార్యక్రమాన్ని ముందుకు తీసుకురావడం జరిగింది. దీనివలన విద్యార్థులకు పునర్జన్మ ఉపయోగపడుతుందని, అలాగే ఈ కార్యక్రమానికి టెలికాస్ట్ చేయడానికి ముందుకు వచ్చినటువంటి మార్త నెట్వర్క్ యజమాన్యం గారికి, అలాగే సిటీ కేమ్ యజమాన్యం గారికి ఈ డిజిటల్ క్లాస్ రూమ్ బోధించడానికి ముందుకు వచ్చిన ఉపాధ్యాయులందరికీ పేరు పేరున కృతజ్ఞతలు తెలియజేసుకుంటున్నాం. ఇది విద్యార్థులు తప్పనిసరిగా తల్లిదండ్రులు విద్యార్థులు మంచి అవకాశంగా భావించి సద్వినియోగం చేసుకుంటున్నారని
కోరుకుంటున్నాం. So, I would like to give you a broad idea about the question paper, English paper 2. Now, as far as the blueprint is concerned, we have, in the second paper particularly, we have three sections. First section is the comprehension, reading comprehension. It consists of 15 marks. The second topic is vocabulary and grammar. You may secure 10 marks. And the third part is C part, creative writing. In that, you may secure 15 marks. So, in this creative writing, you will be given two questions related to major discourses. In those two, you would be given a choice. You may attempt any one of these discourses given. It gives you 10 marks, and that is question number 33. And when you see the 34th question, it is a minor discourse. It consists of 5 marks. So totally, creative writing C part gives you 15 marks. Now, in paper 2, we have 5 major discourses and 3 minor discourses. Now, just have a look at all the discourses given in the paper 2. First of all, major discourses in paper 2 English. The first one is biographical sketch. Next one, essay. Third one is a letter. Fourth one, news report or report. And the other one is speech. So in the examination, in question number 33, they would give any two questions, any two discourses, and you have to attempt only one. So next, minor discourses are under question number 34. There is no internal choice in minor discourses. You have to attempt it compulsorily. You will score 5 marks. So in the second paper, these are the three discourses given. First one is a poster. Other one is an invitation, and the last one is the profile. So, if you look at how to write, how to attempt creative writing in our paper 2 English, now let us see some of the tips. Some of the tips you have to follow while answering creative writing. So, once again, have a look at Section C. Section C, creative writing. In this section, two questions are asked. You need to answer one major discourse and one minor discourse. There is an internal choice for question number 33, writing a major discourse. The following discourses will be tested in this paper. Now, bio sketch, essay, report or news report, letter, and a speech script. Now, read the indicators and tips given in the major discourses of paper 1. You need to write a minor discourse for the 34th question. The minor discourses in For these minor discourses, one mark is awarded for correct layout, design or illustration, and the remaining 4 marks are awarded for contextual relevance, error-free sentences, punctuation marks, spelling and convincing language. Now, let us know something about biographical sketch. If biographical sketch is given in the examination, you have to put in your mind all these points. While answering, you have to include all these points to score more marks. This question is for 10 marks. And these are the features of a biographical sketch. And these features will be seen by the indicators you would present in your biographical sketch. Now, let us look at the features of the biographical sketch. Presenting the details of the person. If the biographical sketch of Stephen Hawking or Gandhiji or Sachin Tendulkar, whatever is given in the exam, first of all, you read the question 2 or 3 times. Ample of time will be given for you to read the question paper. So, first of all, read the question properly, understand it, and while you are giving the third reading, you just put some like marks on your question paper itself, dividing the question into 3 or 4 paragraphs. You may divide the paragraphs according to the details of the person. You can give first paragraph like date of birth, name of his parents should be included in first para. In the second para, you can give the person's education, background, childhood, like that. And in the next para, you can include all the other details of his achievements or anything. In the next para, you can include the awards he has achieved or his date of death or like that. So, all these details should be given in the biographical sketch, dividing it into at least 3 paragraphs, and you can even elaborate it into 4 or 5 paragraphs also. Now, presenting the details of the person, presenting the relevant ideas and information related to that person, and organizing the information in order, including reflections, thoughts and your feelings about that person, and you can put any anecdotes, events or achievements. And also, while you are writing, while you are presenting the biographical sketch, your sentences should be cohesive. Like you have to use some linkers for one paragraph to other paragraph, from one sentence to other sentence also. You have to use some cohesive devices, and also well-formed structure of sentences is very, very important. And we have to observe all the details given in the question should be written in the biographical sketch, like the name of the person, date of birth, place of birth, nationality if given in the question, and his education, about his parents, and if possible, if the information is given in the question, you can even add the details of the siblings and any alma mater, like school, college, like that, and his occupation, and he is known for what. Mostly biographical sketches are written for great people, for what he has famous, for what he is famous for. You have to include all these details also. He is known for so and so, like for he is known for non-violence movement, or he is known for humanity, human service, like that. And also religion, if it is given in the question, you can even mention the religion and his achievements. What did he achieve in his life, and also the awards he has secured. So you can include, you should include all these details in at least 3, 4 or 5 paragraphs, writing all the details given in the question and making it into 2 or 3 paragraphs using simple sentences with cohesive devices. So this is about the, here is the question given. You are asked to write the biographical sketch of P.T. Usha. Now the details given in the question would be like this. Name P.T. Usha, parents Vaidya Lakshmi, her date of birth details, and all the achievements of PT Usha are given in the question. Now you have to develop all these details into paragraphs and you have to write a biographical sketch of PT Usha. Now let us see the first detail. What is her name? PT Usha. Now we have developed this detail into a sentence like this. PT Usha, who is the queen of Indian track and field athlete, was born on 27th June 1964 in Payoli, Kerala, India, in a poor peasant family. See how many details have been covered here. Her name, her date of birth and everything. Now first of all, you have to add a heading. Heading is PT Usha. And this is a tagline you can add on your home. This is a created one. You can create any sentence or a phrase or a word, whatever you feel, after reading the details of the person. Now here we have added the queen of Indian track and field athlete. Now next, her data, her parents. This is the detail given about her parents. Now we have developed those details into a sentence like, her parents are Paithal and Lakshmi and her full name is this one. Her full name is also, we have to know, P.T. Usha. Next, if we look at all the other details developed into a biographical sketch, we can divide the next details into another paragraph. Like in 1973, she was discovered by a dedicated physical education teacher. In 75, she was badly injured while practicing. She participated in so-and-so events. And next paragraph, her achievements. She participated is given in one paragraph and her achievements should be given on we have to include in another paragraph like, in 1982 she got silver medals and in Asian Games, in Olympics. In 85 she have been given this award for best female athlete in Jakarta. In 86 she was awarded with 4 golds and 1 silver in South Asia. So her achievements are given in another paragraph and again we can divide the continuous details into another paragraph like, she runs the Usha School of Athletics in Kerala. She was honored by the government of India in 84 with Arjuna Award, which is conferred to the best Indian player and Padma Shri. Now she is one of the most inspirational women around the globe. This is the sentence we have added. Now like this, you can develop all the details into two or three paragraphs and you can attempt the question by biographical sketch. So these are the features and indicators of a biographical sketch. Now let us see next one here. Now let us observe how an essay should be. First of all, they will be giving you some clues, a topic, and what are the aspects to be included in an essay. So while attempting the question, you have to write a heading, then give the introduction of the essay in one paragraph, and you have to write the content or any arguments or discussions or any given content in the second, third or fourth paragraph, and conclusion should be in the last paragraph. Now let us observe the grammatical aspects of an essay. Now, the tenses should be according to the context. If you start with any tense, you have to continue with the same tense as far as possible. And sequential order of expressions. So while you are expressing ideas also, you have to express them in a sequence. And appropriate vocabulary, like you can use one word substitutes which you have prepared while reading the first and second chapters of your textbook, and you can even develop your vocabulary as you have much time now. And you have to write at least one word. different orthographic words which would score you more marks in the examination. And as a free language, you can even use different types of sentences like simple sentences, compound sentences and complex sentences while you are writing the essay. Or any discourse, while you are attempting any discourse, try to use as many types of grammatical aspects as possible and well-formed sentences. Now, let us look at the features of an essay. First of all, you have to write the title. Title is very important. And then, the thesis statement or the introduction. In the introduction of the essay itself, you have to include what you are going to tell in the coming paragraphs. And then, body and conclusion. You have to give all the details in the body and give a conclusion to the essay. Next, proper division of the paragraphs and supporting examples, if possible. If you are going to give an example, you can also include in second, third or fourth paragraphs. And organization of ideas and proper use of pronouns or linkers, and then presenting the idea in a proper way. So these are the features and indicators of an essay. Now let us look at the examples of an essay on cell phones necessary in teenagers' lives. So if this is the given question in the examination, they would also be giving you some clues, some hints to develop into an essay. And let us just give a look at the essay now. Essay is divided into here 5 paragraphs. And in the first paragraph, introduction of the cell phone and giving, if we are giving the cell phones to the teenagers, what are the advantages and disadvantages? Yes, we are giving an introduction in the first paragraph and conclusion of your idea. Is it necessary or not? Is it useful or not? In the last paragraph, like conclusion. And in the middle, we have given 3 paragraphs. Now, in the first one, yes, cell phones are necessary in teenagers' life. They are necessary because there are many advantages for having a cell phone. Without cell phones, teenagers wouldn't be able to communicate easily with their family, peers and in emergency situations. So this is like introduction. Introduction of the whole essay should be given in the first paragraph. And in the second, third and fourth paragraph, you see, cell phones are necessary in teenagers' life because it is an easy way of contacting your family. If you have to stay at college longer for a specific reason or your family is looking for you and you are out, cell phones make it easy to communicate. Without cell phones, your family would be worried, sick. They wouldn't know exactly where you are and how much longer you would be. With cell phones, they could contact you right away without having to worry about anything. And in the next paragraph also, we have given the advantages of the usage of cell phones in the teenagers, and in the conclusion, in the last paragraph, we have given, so conclusion, this is the linker we have added, so why it is essential for teenagers to have cell phones, because without them it would be very difficult to enjoy life and it could even be a short life if something bad happens and you don't have a cell phone. So this is the pattern and just a layout of an essay. You can even add any examples also, like your friend is out and something happened, without a cell phone what happened. Like that also you can add some examples in the middle paragraph, and in the last paragraph you can conclude the essay. And when we are observing the next discourse, major discourse would be, we will be discussing about the letter writing. In letter writing, of course, we are going to discuss is letter writing. So you might have learned in your school that there are 2 types of letters. One is official or a formal letter, the other one is informal letter. So there are 2 different types of forms how to write a letter. Now let us observe the layout of a personal letter or informal letter. The date and place where you are writing, and you can start the letter with a dear friend or dear mother or whom you are and then body of the letter should be written here. Right, first para should be well wishes, like I am safe here and what about your details, you can write in the first paragraph or introduction of the letter. And in the second para, you should include the purpose, why you are writing the letter, or what is the need for writing a letter. And in the last para, you can tell your regards, like my regards to your parents, to my parents or siblings or your brothers or sisters, like that. And lastly, you can write, you should write yours lovingly, reflects, and address on the envelope, name, house number, village, and district. So this is the layout of a personal letter, and this is the layout of formal letter or official letter. If you are writing a letter to any sub-inspector of police or any newspaper editor, this is the layout. Now from address, name, dash, dash, and to whom you are addressing the letter, sir, and you need to write the subject here. Subject is very important because in official letters, we have to include the main purpose why we are giving this letter. So in a one or two sentences like a subject. And then body of the letter should be directly purpose. Nothing like you are, how are you, or I am fine, this is not at all bothered in a formal letter. You have to directly give the purpose of that and conclusion. What you are asking that higher official or somebody else to do, to take action or to give any notice or something. And then lastly, your faithfully and this. And next, lastly, yes, let us just see the features of the letter. Now, you have to use appropriate language to the context. See, if you are attempting any personal letter, you can use any language, like language to communicate to your parents or brothers or sisters or family members. Like it would be nearly some simple sentences also. But when you are writing the letter to any officials or if it is a formal letter, you have to be precise in writing. You should use less number of sentences, and your point should be direct. Whatever you want to express, you should express in a direct manner, and the letter should be of smaller size also. And appropriate format and layout, and this is the format of a personal letter, and this is the format of a formal. And appropriate conventions of writing, like the salutations, endorsement, like this. These also are the minimum rules to be followed while you are attempting the letter writing question. And expressing ideas sequentially. You have to express sequentially. If you are giving a letter to any sub-inspector, like giving your colleague, roads are not good, then you have to give all the sequential details of the problem in the second, third or fourth paragraphs. And then reflecting appropriate usage of pronouns and linkers. If you are writing a personal letter, you can use all the linkers from sentence to sentence, they should be cohesive. And then reflecting relationship and using well-formed sentences. So these are the main features to be included while you are attempting the question letter writing. And next, we would discuss about an example. Now here is an example of a formal letter. Now, house number, street, Khusrabad, and this is the date where this letter was written, this is the station and date, and this is the place to whom we are writing, to the editor, the Hans India Hyderabad. And as it is a formal letter, we have to give the subject here. Subject means use new English textbook for class 10 regarding. This is the main purpose of writing the letter. And here is the salutation, sir. Then comma, and we are starting the letter into, we have divided the letter into three paragraphs. Now here, I am a regular reader of your esteemed newspaper. I am very much interested in reading the news in Reader's Choice. Every time when I have some feeling, I bring to your notice. I am very much excited to be promoted to class 10 and having new syllabus and books as well. This is the introduction while you are writing the letter. And the body of the letter would be, it's really happy. to be the first batch of the new textbooks. The textbook is designed handy and full of colorful pictures. It has organized by 8 units into different themes, and this is about the textbook. Means in the question you are asked to describe how you are feeling with the first new English textbooks. And then in the last paragraph, thanks to the SCRT for compiling such a beautiful and colorful Our World Through English. This is the title of the textbook. Now here is the last conclusion of the letter. Now thanking you, sir, yours faithfully, dash dash dash. So this is a formal letter given like an example for you. So whatever question is given, you try to attempt at least, and you remember all these details, because these details, if the matter is relevant in the letter, these details also will give you some marks. If it is related to the same given question matter, then these details also will be giving you some marks. Okay, then next we will see, let us see the personal letter. Now here, this boy is asking some money. He has written a letter to his father asking some money for his fees. Now this is a personal letter or informal letter. Now this is the address or place or station we call. This is the station and this is the date when he was writing the letter. That is salutation, my dear father, comma. Then he started the first three paragraphs like this. Now first introduction, I am fine here, I hope that all of our family members are fine too. I am studying well in all subjects. I am very proud to have such loving parents that no one can find all around the world. This is the introduction, like whereabouts, how you are, and asking about the parents also. Now in the next paragraph, you are writing, you should write the purpose of the letter. Why you have written a letter? What is the purpose? Now in the second paragraph, it is a bit difficult for me to write you this time. It's time to pay my term 2 fee, rupees 5000, to the college. It would be pleasure to me if you send me the money immediately. The principal has ordered me to pay the amount by 16th itself without pay. See, this is the purpose of the letter. In the first paragraph we have given the introduction, and in the second one the purpose, and in the last one regards to your parents or brothers or sisters. Now hope my lovely sister is fine and going to school. Do convey my regards to mom and grandfather. This is the conclusion of the letter. And lastly, your loving son, Swag. Now in the last we should give the address to whom the letter should reach. Now here is the address, like to Shravan, house number, and this is the bit along with the pin code we have written the informal letter. Next, let us see the features of a news report. This is another discourse. This gives you 10 marks if you attempt it in a proper way. And those who are regular readers of newspapers, articles, they would be aware of writing a news report in a better way. And it's not more time, it is not too late. You also start reading newspaper articles at least from now, so that you would be aware of how a newspaper news report should be written. Now here, these are the features of a report or a news report. Now features, it should be accurate and concise, clear, and the structure of the sentences should be well structured. And now here, the format of the news report should be, or any report or news report should be, first of all, you have to record all sequences of actions. If some event happened in your neighborhood or in your school or somewhere you came across, then you have to note down all the details in a sequential manner and you have to present it in the report. And interpretation of these events or facts. If somebody is giving any their opinion or their thoughts, you have to note down all those also in the news report. And evaluation of the facts. What happened there, the news report should give the facts to the report. And also discussion of the outcomes. What would happen after this? If something happened in the world like this, then what will come in the next week? That would be discussion of the outcomes. And lastly, you have to conclude it, and your recommendations are also included in the MCQ. And what are the tips you have to follow while answering the news report question? Now, your language should be clear and simple. You can write it in a simple language, and also sentences may be short. You can write small sentences also. You need not go for complex or compound sentences. And also, you develop the news report into paragraphs. It should be 5, 4, 3, any number of paragraphs depending on the context of the question. And use active voice rather than passive voice. If the news report demands the interpretation of any person standing there, if people are wanted to give their own voice, you can record all of those voices in active voice. And also good grammar and punctuations. Those are also very important. Now let us see an example of a news report of Swachh Bharat, Swachh Vidyalaya. Now just see the headline. Headline means the heading of a news report. Right, it should be usually written in words or phrases to attract the readers towards the content. Just by looking at the title of it itself, the heading of it itself, readers would be attracted to read and probe into the details of the news. And also byline. Byline means it tells that who wrote the article, means who wrote the article and when. Now introduction. Introduction here is, it summarizes the main points of the article, that like who, what, when and where. Who did that? What happened at that time? When did that took place? And where did it happen? So all these details should be given in one or two sentences in the first paragraph itself, so that the readers, just by looking at the first paragraph itself, they would understand what is the matter. If they want all the other details, they would continue to read the whole news. Now here, and the body. The body should be, it is the complete illustration of the incident or something that has taken place. And now, this is an example. Write a news report on a clean and green in your school. Now, if your school has conducted Swachh Bharat, then give a news report. Give a report to the newspaper about the Swachh Bharat mission in your school. Now, this is the heading, like Swachh Bharat, Swachh Vidyalaya, Times News Bureau, 20th October, November, 4 o'clock. This is the place. And in the first paragraph itself, we have to give most details of the incident or the event. Now today, students at Government High School collaborated with the Environmental Club to improve the school ground by the making of the garden and picking up litter in the name of Swachh Bharat, Swachh Vidyalaya. So the whole details of the report should be in should be included in the first introduction. Then go for the details. Then go for the illustration also. Now, not only do trees benefit our environment, says student volunteer Ramo. Means this is a quotation. This is the direct speech, active voice given by the person now. But they also improve the visual quality of our school. Now, indeed, the high school area looks like the sense of community spirit. And Prakruti nursery of Allapur donated so and so, and all the details should be given in the next coming paragraph. And lastly, what is the conclusion of it? Means the benefits of this project do not end at environmental friendly. The school also had a fundraiser where every student would participate in the rally in groups around the city to raise funds to make it an endless program. The headmaster, Sarpanch, MPTC and all the other community leaders participated and appreciated the children. So this would be the conclusion of a news report. Now another news report is given. Another news report, a picture is given. Just observing the picture also we can write the news report. Like, look at the picture below and write a news report on the sense, on the scene, sorry. You may make use of the following hints. Now by looking at the picture, we would understand that there is a heavy traffic jam on this road, on this bridge. Now what happened, where did it happen, when did it happen, and who were the people affected? with all these details, we can write a news report. Now here is the news report given. Unprecedented traffic jam in Hyderabad. This is the headline. Now, in Hyderabad, November 15, 2017. This is the case and time. Now, first paragraph, in the first paragraph itself, we have to give all the details. Like Hyderabad witnessed an unprecedented traffic jam in major parts of the city, especially in the southern and western parts of the city. The never seen before traffic diversions due to repair works led to chaos on roads. Arguments fumed between the motorists and policemen, aggravating the situations at several places. So this is a problem occurred in some parts of the city because of the traffic jam. So this is the introduction we have given to that. And here these are the examples. These are the problems which are the vehicles there, like ambulances and so on. So details from Nampally to Mahabalipuram. And what happened, even ambulance was stuck in that traffic jam and policemen are trying to do evacuate the place. Now, the family members of the patients were pleading and arguing with the police to clear the way for them to reach the hospital and almost broke into tears. Now, so these are the details given. So, what are the problems? Because of the traffic jam, some patients were stuck in the ambulance in the traffic jam, and these are the details of that. So like this, you have to divide the news report into 2 or 3 or 4 paragraphs giving all these details. Now next, we will go to the speech. The last one of this 10 marks discourses would be speech. Now, while writing a speech, you have to put all these things in your mind while presenting about speech. Now here, the speech writing is used to express your views on the public in the public on a dais. There are some features of a good speech. Before getting onto the dais, one has to plan it. It is important to deviate sensibly to another topic. Now these are the features of a speech. Now while starting a speech, features of a good speech are now salutation or greeting. So while starting a speech, you can put all these starting phrases in your mind. Now one would be respected principal, teachers and my dear students or friends, if it is in a school, or honorable sarpanch, NPTC or sarpanch, principal, teachers and my dear friends, and organizers, the minister of finance, honorable sarpanch, so these are the useful phrases while you are writing a speech, while you are starting a speech. And in the next one, disclosure of topic. In the next sentence, you have to disclose the topic, on which topic you are going to give a speech. So the topic would be like this. Today, as we are observing the Children's Day, and that is, then you can add all the details. As today, we are gathered here to observe so and so. And he's happy to tell you that. And I wish you all like a happy Teacher's Day or a happy Republic Day, like that. And it would be happy to be the part of this occasion of our school day or school anniversary or any other day or any Haritaharam day, like that. And next, third point would be narration of facts, presentation of data and relevant examples, etc. You can give any examples or you can give any information in the next paragraph. And in last, you have to draw the conclusion. Now, drawing conclusion in an innovative and imaginative way is also very important while you are attempting the question speech. Now, useful paragraphs. I am really thankful to you for giving me such an opportunity. This would be the last paragraph or the conclusion of a speech. Or you can thank you one and all. Or thank you, Jai Hind. Or it's really proud to be here with you. Thank you, and etc. So these would be the conclusions of a speech while you are giving, while you are writing the speech script in your examination.
Okay.
An example of a speech to be given on a teacher's day. Now you can start the speech script by introduction like, Honorable Sarpanch, SMC Chairperson, Chairman, respected Headmaster and my dear friends, Good morning, one and all. First of all, I wish you everyone a happy Teacher's Day. This is the introduction. In the first paragraph, we have to write it. And in the next paragraph, in the coming 2, 3, 4 or any number of paragraphs, we can give the details of why we are celebrating Teacher's Day and on what occasion and how we are celebrating in our school like that. Now here, it would be happy to me to be the part of this occasion of Teachers Day. And Teachers Day is celebrated as a tribute to the valuable contribution made by teachers to the society by imparting knowledge and enlightening and shaping the career of students. Celebration of Teachers Day is fairly popular in many countries across the world. This is the next paragraph here. Now here is the relevance. Now in India, 5th September is observed as Teachers Day on the birth date of Dr. Sarvepalli Radhakrishnan as a mark of token to the contribution of Dr. Sarvepalli Radhakrishnan, who was a staunch believer of education and was the well-known diplomat, scholar, president of India and above all a teacher. So this is the main content of the speech. Now lastly, we are in the conclusion, like, on this auspicious day, we owe to the nation to be the best citizens. I am really thankful to you for giving me such an opportunity. Thanking you, Jay. So this is the format of writing a speech. Even if you are given in the Independence Day or Republic Day or any school day, you should write this type of format. Now next, coming to the minor discourses, the question number would be question number 34, and there is no internal choice. You will be given one question to write the minor discourse and you have to attempt it, and it is very simple. Even if you write small details also, you may score 4 to 5 marks very, very easy. First of all, you just start a minor discourse on a fresh page. Don't just continue on another page where you have written some grammar or reading comprehension. Start C section on a fresh page. You draw a layout. Just draw the borders and then put the given details which are given in the question. You include all the details in that layout itself. Then it will be easy for you to score more marks. Now here, poster. Now let us look at the poster. So while coming to your school also, you might be observing many posters on the road. What is attractive in that poster? The picture. Yes. So relevant picture should be there in a poster. And who has given the poster and who are participating in that event, the date of that event, time of the event, venue of the event, and what are the details of the event, and who has organized that event. So all these details should be included in a poster. And if possible, you may use pencils or colored crayons, mostly crayons. Even you can use crayons, but marks may not be specially given to crayons. But if you use colored crayons, your answer would be, your poster would be attractive. And now these are the details you have to include while writing a poster. Now here the format should be title. First of all, put a title to your poster, and authors, or if there are any authors, you can include introduction, objective of the poster, material and methods of it, results of it, conclusion and acknowledgement. So these are the details you have to be in the poster. Now here, this is the layout of a poster. First of all, draw an outline on a page, then you start a poster. Now first of all, title of the poster, this is mandatory. You have to give the title of the poster. And then the introduction. Here you can add a figure, table, methods and results and discussion should be here, and another table is given here, and conclusion should be here. These are the places where you can add these details. If it is any ID number given here, you can include here. Now let us observe a poster already drawn by a student like you. Now here is a poster, like this is the heading here, Paper Tea Handicraft Mela. Stunning creations with the hands of great artisans. This is the introduction and heading and another detail here. An excuse in 10 days handicraft exhibition with 50 stalls. Now here two tables are given. If there are no details to be published here, you can draw a picture here. Any picture of any handicrafts like bangles or sarees or whatever are available in the handicraft mela, you can draw here. Now here the chief guest is MLA of our constituency, venue Junior College Ground, Solur, Mahbubabad. Date is from here to here and time would be 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. Now who are welcome here means all are welcome. Now admission is free, everybody can enter into that. And directly sales and live demo from artisans. So these are the details you have to furnish in the poster, and almost all the details will be provided for you in the question paper itself. Just you have to do is only the thing is you have to include all the given details in the poster in the format. Like here some details, here some details, and you may draw any number of designs also, like a star, like a square, or a rectangle, or any prism. So you can add any number of pictures. The main motto of a poster is it should be attractive to the readers. And mostly you can use all these type of salient features in a poster. Now let us see a printed poster. Now here is a printed poster of Bloom the New Year with Handlooms. Silsila Handloom Products Exhibition Come Sale. This is the heading of it. And products made by master weavers. Inaugurated by Honorable Chief Minister Telangana on 24/12/2016 at 10 a.m. So these details are very very important. Like where is the place, venue, exhibition grounds, Hyderabad. Venue is important, date is important, time is important, and who are invited. Now here entry is free. If there is any entry ticket, you can write like entry ticket 100 rupees. Like that also you can write the details. Now here, attractive discount, this is to attract the reader. Now see, you can observe the saris, some bangles, purses. So these are the items which are to be sold in the exhibition come sale place. Now, and organized by, who has organized this name? Now Ministry of Textiles and Handlooms, Telangana, and all are welcome. So your poster also should look like this. With some colors, necessary pictures, and all the details given in the question. So if you write all these things, definitely you will be scoring 5/5 marks in the minor discourse. The other thing in the minor discourse, other question might be an invitation. Invitation also might look like the poster with all the details, or you can write it in the form of a letter also. Like inviting through sentences and paragraphs, or invitation with all the details given as if we have seen in the poster also. Now what are the important features to be in the invitation means, these are the tips here they are given. Now express events details, details of the event should be expressed, occasion, purpose of the invitation, appropriate format should be there like layout and design and everything. And layout, design, brevity, persuasive language, well-formed sentences, and invitee details, means who is inviting to what occasion, when is the occasion, what is the purpose of the occasion, and at what time. Now these are the tips to be followed. Now here is the layout of an invitation here. So though it might not be clear to you, here is an invitation given by Anisha and Akhila. These two girls are inviting all of us to their friend's marriage with this group. So this is the matter given here, and these are the details of the place, time and venue of the marriage, and these are the invitees. Now let us look at some tips. While you are answering the invitation, you can put all these tips in your mind while starting an invitation. Now, so the important points to be mentioned are the name of the program or invitation, venue, date, time, name of the invitee, and border with some design. So these are all given in the question paper itself. You have to just put all the details in your answer. Start it on a fresh page, end it in that page itself, try to end it in one page, and put some design and colors to the invitation so that it looks attractive. And useful phrases while you are starting an invitation, you can start like this: you are cordially invited to the birthday of so and so, or to the marriage of so and so, or whatever the occasion might be. And we request the pleasure of your company at the celebrations of dash. Now here, request you honor of presence at it. And we would be delighted if you would join us on a New Year party or any wedding anniversary or anything. And we are happy to announce the wedding of the people, place, and the venue, time. All the details would be added here. Now, because you have been very important in their lives, so and so people request your presence at their wedding on so and so date at so and so place. So this is another format, like writing a letter, inviting the people in the format of writing a letter in words and in paragraphs and in sentences. So this is another format. Now another example. Now here, prepare an invitation for Independence Day celebrations at your school. So this is the name of the school. This is the occasion, 65th Independence Day celebration. This is the occasion. Now we are delighted to welcome you to the 65th Independence Day celebrations at our school grounds. The chief guest, Honorable Judge C.V. Srikant, will inaugurate the function. These are the given details. Now date and time is 15th August 2014 at 8 a.m. Venue would be the same school grounds, ABCD High School. What are the details of the program? Here are the details. At 8 a.m. flag hoisting, 8:20 presentation, 9 o'clock cultural program, and 9:30 seat distribution. Now who has given the invitation? That is very important. The headmaster, ABCD High School. So all these details will be given in the question itself. The only thing is, you may include all these things in the answer. Now let us look at another example. I think this would be very easy for you to answer. Like it also looks like a poster here. Like you can use invitation, school exhibition, school name, design. You can add any design here of our date, February, time. And these are the details: first prize, second prize, and third prize. And the lunch starts 12:30 p.m. and inaugurated by so and so, district education officer Mr. Babar, and venue would be the school auditorium. Elocution program, competitions for on the topic of my favorite scientist, and essay writing competition for use of science and technology, and cultural programs 3 p.m. onwards are welcome. This is the school day invitation. So you can present it in this format or like sentences and paragraphs. So whichever format you can choose. But the only thing is, include all the given hints, details in the question. Those should be in the answer. Now, let us see the last one in our 5 marks minor discourses would be a profile. The profile would be only a minor details of a person. If you are given a biographical sketch, you can write the profile. So my biographical sketch would be all the details and all the descriptions and all the explanations in that. A profile would carry only the details in less words, in less sentences, and it would be easy for us to just look at the details of a person, personal details. Now here, features of a profile would be necessary details of the person, relevant ideas, organization of the data, appropriate cohesiveness, and well-formed sentences, and a brief note. So these are the features of a profile. And here, indicators would be name of the person given, date of birth, his personality. these are the minor details of a profile here. Now let us see an example of a profile. Observe a profile. If you are asked to give your profile, or if you are applying for a job of management accountant, this would be your profile. It means your profile should look like this. Now here, I am a commercially aware business analyst and a qualified management accountant with over 14 years of experience working with high profile global organizations. Analytical with strong system skills, I specialize in structuring, standardizing and streamlining financial reporting processes to provide more accurate and productive systems that enhance data visibility and facilitate better business decisions. So these are the plus points of a person for applying to the post of a management accountant. Now this is the profile. Profile means all the details, not all the details, but which are relevant to the post should be included in the profile. Now let us look at another profile. Now let us look at another example of Sachin Tendulkar's profile. Now here Sachin Tendulkar's whole details are given in the form of a biographical sketch. Now imagine that he is going to apply for the post of a cricket coach to the team of India. Now we are asked to prepare a personal profile for him based on the information provided below. Now this is the profile of Sachin Tendulkar. Name Sachin Ramesh Tendulkar. Date of birth 14th April 1973 Mumbai, and field cricket, member Indian international cricket. Now the batting style would be right handed batsman. The bowling style right arm off break leg break, and number of centuries in his test cricket would be 51, and number of centuries in ODI is 35. Positions held captain of Indian team for 1996 World Cup, and man of the match in ODIs 57 times. Awards received Arjuna Award and Vision Cricketer of the Year, Rajiv Khel Ratna, Padma Shri. Now if you are giving any sequence of an argument, if you are starting an argument, you can write firstly. If you are adding any sentence, you can add secondly, thirdly, and lastly or finally also you can add. So these underlined words act as linkers for your discourses. Now sequential narrative. Now to begin a sentence, before, afterwards, then, finally, after that, first, in the end. So if you are acting, if you are writing a narrative, first if you start, you can write before God I declare, in the end this thing happened, and come and say goodbye before you go, after lunch, let's eat and go to a movie afterwards, you will get the job in the end. And in making conditions also, you can use as long as, providing that, unless. Like, as long as we are together, I will be happy. So this is a condition. When you are expressing conditions, you can use these type of linkers. Unless you have a better idea, you will follow my plan. Providing that it is not their own money, they will spend it all. Now to join any words or clauses, you can write as long as, but only, provided that. So these are some of the linkers you can use. And while expressing contrast in opposite sentences, you can use these like, however he did it, it was very clever. On the other hand, there are some disadvantages. Susan was a plain woman, nevertheless, she had many boyfriends. So these are two opposite statements. When you are giving two opposite statements, you can use these linkers. Now for joining words, but, you can use yet, even though, despite, in spite of. Like, I may be old, but I can still ride a bike. Even though it was raining, this thing happened. And you could help us with the cooking, or better yet, why don't you set the tap? Now at the end of that you can use though also. So these are some of the instances we are using linkers. Now if you are giving any purpose, you can use in order to, in order that, and in order to. See, here are some examples like, you don't need a degree in order to work as an expert. She studied hard so that she might become a doctor. So when you are giving the purpose also, and in the end also you can give the linker. Like, we will do our best for this purpose. We need to raid the castle. We must find some sword.